So we've just recently received news from our sponsor, DARPA, which is part of the Department of Defense, that they'd like us to take one of our 5 strongly neutralizing antibodies and develop it as a gene-delivered product and test it in humans. We believe that Duke will be the first to test a gene-delivered antibody for SARS coronavirus in humans.
That's where we isolate from people who have recovered from COVID-19 antibodies from their blood. We're developing those antibodies to give to people who are at high risk for contracting the disease.
The manufacturing team will then be preparing that so that we'll have enough material so that we can do a small phase 1 clinical trial that will start probably in January of 2021.
With the passive vaccine, you have to give that set of antibodies to someone every month or so in order to protect them. To be a stopgap until an active vaccine is made. Now, the active vaccine work is going well. And the first set of vaccines actually look quite good in the sense that they're inducing the kinds of antibodies that we want. We're very optimistic that for this type of infection that we will have a vaccine, and whether it'll be 6 months or a year or longer, that's hard to predict. We formed a partnership with the Department of Energy with the scientists down at Los Alamos National Laboratory. If this virus mutates away from the vaccines that are being made, or if another virus comes out of animals the way this one did, we want to be ready.
Right now, we are primarily using cryo-electron microscopy to look at the structure of the spike, which is a molecule which is on the exterior of the SARS-CoV-2 virus. It helps the virus enter into cells, and that is the target for antibodies. We design based on the structure molecules, which will lock the spike, and then we transfer over those molecules to BART once we show that it works. So the hope is you'll be able to create artificially a mimic of that spike, which will then be a vaccine.
So that shows the spike bound to an antibody here.
Whatever we do has to be better than what's being done already by the pharmaceutical industry and complement those. We want to have a lot of shots on goal in order to have the best chance of getting a safe and effective vaccine as quickly as possible.
Saliva is a very easy type of specimen to collect. You can give someone a little cup, they can spit in it a few times, then you can go do your analysis. Our average is about 80% concordance between the swab and the saliva. I think if we could get it up to 95%, something in that range, then that's something that's reasonable.
What society needs is a rapid, sensitive, accurate test that's inexpensive, that perhaps costs $10 or less. Right now, it costs a Duke about $92 a test.
You know, sometimes things look so simple when you think about it, you know, spit in a cup and then measure something, and yet it takes a lot of work in trying to work out the dynamics of that as an appropriate specimen for translating to clinical use.
Well, what we are doing is the right way to do it. And we are not just taking one approach, we're taking multiple approaches. So, you know, we are covering our bases.
We also have the advantage within the Vaccine Institute of having a wonderful clinical trials team that allows us to quickly do these trials.
Until we have a vaccine that proves to be effective and or having treatment modalities that can help those that they get infected, this is going to take a village. It's going to take everybody paying attention to this and doing their part.